This figure basically shows the thought process of those research groups who think NGM does play a certain role, in fact significant role. This I have reproduced from Magoya and Klassen. I have given reference, but what they have done, this figure originally is from Tim Napierman's work, was director in JKMRC. He conceptualized this whole thing. What basically he says is that a major reason, or at least one reason for misplacement, is it is not exactly NGM, but how long those NGM particles remain without reporting to any specific product within the system. And if you look at this curve, he basically says that if it is high NGM, then residence time requirement for those particles to report to any product, not necessarily right product, to any product is long. This is your card density, this is the range, plus minus 0.05 or 0.1, and these are the NGM particles which keep on continuously remain retained within the cyclone till the report to some product. Now he argues that if percentage of these particles is large, then this phenomena would be stronger and stronger, but continuously feed is coming. So, they may like to stay longer to report to the right product, they do not get, they are pushed. Now, when they are pushed, they can go anywhere. And this is how he says that NGM affects the performance of the dense media cyclone. And he says, larger the percentage of dense media cyclone in feed to dense media cyclone, larger is misplacement. But only in very few cases this kind of specific relationship has been obtained. Very few cases. In large number of cases, over the entire spectrum of NGM values, say from 5 to 60, 65, it is very difficult to get this kind of relationship. But one interesting thing you see, percentage misplacement of clean coal to reject is very high compared to the percentage misplacement of reject to clean coal. Okay, there is a significant difference. Why this difference is coming? Why displacement is not symmetrical? One possible reason is that this is our float curve, this is our relative density curve, right? And suppose this is 1.2, this is 2.2, card density is say 1.5. So, this is 1.45, this is 1.55. So, let us say plus minus 0.05 is the basis, and this is the NGM range. Okay. Now, if I say NGM in this range is 30, that does not necessarily mean we have here 15, here we have 15. It could be anything, 10 and 5, sorry, 10 and 20, it could be 20 and 10 also. It entirely depends on the shape of this curve. So, if within the NGM range, percentage of material in the cleaner coal side is more, displacement could be more. But if percentage of material on reject side is more, then why should there be larger displacement, large displacement? We will come to that point little later on. But this is the broad general trend. We may not get relationship, but by and large in every operation we find that displacement is more for clean coal to reject or lighter fraction to heavier fraction. Figure 8, what I am now going to show, it is from Tata Steel plant and we got EP of 0.049. And approximately 90% of the partition curve is within plus minus 0.05 of the cut density. But what is the cut density? 1.63. Okay. But displacement is high. But in this high, if it is 5.893% total displacement calculated, 5.083% is clean coal in reject. Only some fraction of reject is coming to clean coal. Side by side, later on I will show this figure 9, which is partition curve typical for jigs, also used for our coal. And cut density, as a partition curve, okay, let me show. Otherwise, right. This is the partition curve for Jharia coal, low volatile coking coal. The first partition curve what I had shown was pretty sharp, if you recall. That was from an Australian set of data or US, I do not know, Monishankar will know, but not Indian. The moment we come to India, our partition curve becomes like this, error area larger, more flat curve. Where is the jig curve? This is the curve for jig. We said efficiency is less. See how flat it is. But now let us look at this table. This is the you read the table. Feed size is typical for the equipment under Indian conditions. Cut density for jig is very typical, greater than 1.6. Cut density for DMC 1.63 is a bad cut density in Australia. But in India we have no choice. NGM value of 35, so called NGM, whether plus minus 0.1 or 0.05. This is 35 or 23, but this is typical for Indian coal, nothing big about that. For jig again, small and jigs can operate only with lower level of so called NGMs. EP for DMC is 0.049, jig big inefficient almost double, but look at the organic efficiency values. organic efficiency for DMC is lower compared to jig, and for jig it is pretty high. Whatever lighter ash part, lighter particles with lower ash, everything is reporting in jig along with water to clean coal. So when we are assessing on the basis of ash, we are getting a very good performance. Organic efficiency is high because it is average ash value what we are considering. The example I gave yesterday, that average of 30% ash, it can be 1000 different permutation of combinations because your ash content varies from 0 to 100 of particles. And this is what the problem lies when you want to analyze the performance of the equipment in the plant. Plant, why jigs are so, it is relatively inefficient, all those things, but still why jigs are so popular in India, and it will continue to do so for at least next 20-25 years. He plant manager is bothered about organic efficiency, he is not bothered about EP. I am getting 96.8%.
Yeah, but your sizes, feed sizes are different. So can we really compare it, the two different
feed sizes? No, feed sizes are different, but feed sizes are the typical feed sizes for these two equipment. I am not comparing that way.
So actually that way can we really compare if the sizes are different, because your separation efficiency not.
No, that way that way separation mechanism also is different.
Yeah. No,
separation mechanism is completely different.
Difficulty in processing, because in a fluid based any medium, your size goes down, your performance goes down. It is well known, and it is a simple fluid mechanical phenomena. So if I compare these two, I have to take the same feed size, otherwise I cannot tell that.
But what at the beginning what I said, that these are the typical feed size ranges for the two equipment used in India. Yes, they are different. That is true what you said. And this is now how do we assess which equipment we say superior, which equipment we say inferior. This is the crux of the problem. And you will see little later on, we keep on talking that perhaps below the size of 2 mm, 1 mm, particles do not really get separated. Whatever, wherever water carries them, they go. If water is not able to carry them, they don't go. Zero, for example, there is a very good book of South Australian Coal Preparation Society. They wanted to determine, I think I have reproduced that table, size by size EP for the different equipment. For example, for jig, for less than 1 mm, they could not find EP. They could not plot the curve.
Even your so-called NGM, if you look at, these are two different coals. That is.
Of course. I am not comparing. I am trying to point out the difficulties in assessing the performance. What measure do I take to assess the performance? How do I say this is good, this is bad, or this is better, that is worse? These two are conflicting. This is the point. I think we will skip this because time will not permit. You please go through the notes. I mean, how partition curve behaves, that is I just tried to explain. Yeah. One reason why we do not achieve the EP in our dense media cyclone operations in India compared to the dense media cyclone operations elsewhere is possibly that our card densities are much higher, 1.65 while recovering the clean coal, compared to in those countries where it is rarely more than 1.5. Now the moment card density increases, you have to add more and more magnetite. and more you add magnetite, this kind of relationship may emerge. That means equipment performance, whether it is jig, whether it is Denspedia cyclone, equipment performance would deteriorate with the increase in card density. Best performing equipment, card density 1.4 and less, 1.4 to 1.6, reasonably good, but beyond 1.6, it is very difficult to achieve an EP of 0.05 or less. Even 0.05 is difficult to get. And the whole set of problems starts with magnetite. See, this is the relationship, broad relationship between card density and AP depending on narrowly sized particles. From the feet to the same cleaning equipment, samples were collected and their and they were subjected to EP determination through float sink, size by size, not as a composite sample. And in each and every case, EP deteriorates as card density increases. But that deterioration, here you have a cluster. Here you have a broad cluster, but the moment you move out of this cluster, the relationship literally jumps away from each other. It almost, the performance deterioration literally keeps on jumping as the particle size decreases, correspondingly with the increase in card density. And this is the range, this is the typical range wherein separation takes place in India for all coal cleaning operations, where we recover clean coal. When we do three product cleaning, this is the range where our card densities are generally maintained, whereas in all other countries card densities are here. This is the Australian standard, Australian practice. So, if feet size is plus 4 mm and card density is 1.4 or less, then a anticipated or accepted, not any, sorry, acceptable DMC EP is 0.02. If the size is minus 2 plus 0.05, then it is 0.04. And if card density is 1.6, 1.5 to 1.6 or even little more than 1.6, then minimum EP is 0.03 for plus 4 mm, maximum permissible is 0.06 for this minus 2 plus 0.5. This is the standard Australian stipulation, whereas you will, it will be very difficult to locate a washer in India with DMC where EP is less than this 0.05, even the best operated washeries. And this 0.05 is attained for a composite feed with a size of say 13 to 0.5 millimeter, not minus 2 plus 0.5 or 15 to 0.5 millimeter. Why this is important? Because when we say 13 to 0.5, when we say 13 to 0.5, it is very important what is the percentage distribution of the particle sizes within that range. 13 to 6 will give you a different TP, 6 to 2 will give you a different TP, 2 to 0.5 again a different TP. This is a very interesting relationship. Ideally, it should be same media density versus cut density, but this is not what is happening, and this is what I told in the previous one, that it is not media density which is the cut density, and we can theorize, we can make lot of calculation through washability analysis, but it virtually never happens that washability cut density is reproduced in the actual plant. And this happens not only with DMC, but this happens with jigs also. Various reasons we talked little bit earlier, media contaminated with fine coal, finer the particles, media contamination probability is more. What is that fine coal? 35% ash with lot of clay, lot of slimes, some other dirt brought by the raw coal, and particularly damaging is clay, which continuously remain in suspension, stick to the surface of magnetite particles, coal particles, and they keep on reducing the media density because clay has lower density. The moment you find that a media density is dropping, let us add more magnetite to offset that. More you do that, your viscosity again increases. Different countries, they have developed their own specification or guidelines for operating the plants. For example, in South Africa, concentration of solid particles in a medium is usually maintained at 25 to 45% by volume. And if you start finding what is the basis you will find essentially there practical, whatever they gain through operating the plants, that is the basis. Similarly, magnetite size specification for different cut density range, this is again South African specification. Different countries have different specification depending on their coal, what they have, but because South African coal has a significant similarity with Indian coal, so I reproduced for South African coal, because bulk of their coal, not bulk, I think the whole coal is of Gondwana origin. Sorry, in case of Australia, there is some point part where Gondwana coal is there. Anyway, so 1.35 to 1.50 has a different range. Again, you please remember, percentage of less than 44 micron means stable suspension, but maximum stability is brought by minus 10 micron, but maximum viscosity is also brought by minus 10 micron. So, it is not only less than 44, also important is less than 10 micron. And 2.25 to 2.50, that is usually when we do secondary cleaning to recover reject, which actually is not reject, which can be used for some combustion, I mean typical for low rank coal or low heat value coal. So, again, for that cut density is different. Media is such an important issue that other than India, virtually all other major coal producing countries, they have done huge amount of work to prepare and circulate operating guidelines for all their coal preparation or coal cleaning plants, whether it is Australia or South Africa or US. The stability, I already told you, stability and viscosity, these are very critical issues. Stability is good, but stability also brings viscosity. If you do not get stability, then also is a problem for you, because that means media, suppose this is your card density, 0 means when the shift begins, and let us say this is 24 hours. When there was manual or semi-automatic control, then this card density would keep on varying like this. Over a period of 24 hours. Now, it is reduced, but it keeps on varying, it is never stable, it cannot be stable. You can say that yes, variation is less, variation definitely is less, but even this variation is a very troubling factor for Indian coal. There is a commercial concept called yield reduction factor. That means drop in yield per 1% increase in ash. Suppose target ash is 17, it is dropping to 16. So for this 1% drop, what will be the corresponding drop in yield? This value is very high in India. So even this minute variation, if it affects an ash change by even say 0.5%, that can reduce your yield by 1.5%. And if it is, as I told you in the previous one, if it is a 400 TPH plant, even 0.5, 1% drop in yield is a huge, huge, huge mass of coal lost, clean coal lost. Just a minute. Just let us recall these figures, how EP changes, how EP deteriorates with card density, right? And we can see that if particle size is 1 to 0.5, then at a card density of say 1.65, we get EP of around say 0.07. And if card density is say 1.85, we get EP of 0.075 or something like that. I mean, as the card density increases, EP keeps on increasing. These data generated through coal which are not known to be high NGM coal. All right. So we cannot say NGM, NGM, NGM. We cannot say that. Now let us look at this figure. This figure was derived by Frank Kaplan. This is your, let us say, magnetite. This is 1.0, this is 1.5. up to say 1.525 or so, there is little change in viscosity. But then as it increases, particularly not even 2.0, say around 1.75 or 1.80 upward, how viscosity changes, apparent viscosity. Right? This is possibly the reason why misplacement is so high, EP is so poor, one of the reasons, and not really NGM, that we get low EP operations in Indian plants. Even if we keep aside everything else, that best practice, best design, everything else. This is a data set again from a Tata Steel plant, and this is the sized cleaning parameters, and you can see 13 to 6 mm cut density is different, yield is different, same target ash for clean coal, 3 to 0.5 yield different, and like that. Two parallel cyclones fed through a distributor, identical, apparently identical feed with maximum size of 20 millimeter. But you can see that it is not really identical feed, because your D90 varies, 90% passing size varies, 80% passing size varies, that means that the D50 varies. That means while feeding to the parallel cyclones through distributor, we are assuming it is the same coal, but it is not. And this is again a typical problem of working in a plant and not only assessing the performance, but doing the efficiency analysis, modeling, whatever you may try to do. Why it is difficult? Because in all these plants, in all parallel units, clean coal streams are parallel, but all the reject streams straight away from the cyclone, they converge. You cannot collect samples separately for reject for each of the cyclones. Reject sample would be your combined one. You have no access, no way. We tried a lot, we could not. But anyway, because clean coal could be collected separately. So, we did a little bit of approximation, we shut down the plant, this, that, all those things, lot of tinkering, and tinkering was not adequate, but still you see the difference in the EP between the two. In one you are getting 0.049, in another you are getting 0.038. What the plant people did, they basically tried to fix a pipe through the vortex for the two parallel units. So that, and two in two different vessels, spillage was there, but anyway, I am unable to explain. For example, identical operating condition, identical cyclone, everything same, but because during distribution feed does change, possibly that is the reason why. And it is not feed only, it is feed slurry. Feed slurry means feed plus magnetite. Possibly that is the reason, I do not know, maybe some more reason could be there, that we get a different performance for both.
Simply the distributor design problem.
Not sampling, it is distributor.
It is a distributor design problem.
So is it consistent
with it? It is very common.
Is it consistently this way?
You never get identical performance. Always there is difference.
Geometric issue
It is not geometric issue. What we found that after you operate it for half an hour, 45 minutes, somewhere some material gets stuck up, so your flow gets reduced through one, somewhere some tearing takes place, so that affects the flow. These kind of things keep on happening too frequently.
See, actually, if your distributor is having some bends, okay, so it will entirely change the flow path and everything. For magnetite, the classification behavior of magnetite is also very important.
We talked about that in the morning.
So that table 7, what you showed as a CPC. So I may not need very fine particles. But
yeah,
when you are having lesser density, then it is more of a
free settling.
So what will happen if I have a little bit coarser particle, they will just settle. So, how much of magnetite is basically being used for separation, or it is just entering and going up or going down, then it is not remaining in suspension. So that is basically the main issue with the coal, I think. So that is the problem.
That is in the previous session we
said about the purity and all.
No, no, purity forget. We were talking about another probability in the session before. That in a dense medium cyclone, the Contd density what we talk about, this is basically a kind of average or composite Contd density.
Contd density has got no meaning actually. Contd density itself is a variable, it has got no meaning.
Exactly.
We should start with what is our target and what we have got. We should not look at the inside what is happening. We cannot tell with this. You change any delta x anywhere, your Contd density changes. So it is not a fixed parameter. Why should we bother about Contd density and EP? That is what I always debate.
That is what plant operators also say.
No. So that is what
in their own way. That why to talk about EP?
I wanted to pollute this mind of this coal preparation engineers by telling all this, but not in the talk. I said that. I said in different class, you know, in my room. So that is what we have to think of. Now here actually if you look at these operations from a fluid mechanical point of view, you can get to, you can understand many more things than you know what is to be done. Yeah, so that's why I wrote that time. That
I saw you are writing something.
Imagine life without EP. Imagine life of coal preparation people without EP. What will happen? So you have to think out of that, you know. Yeah, so that is the very purpose of this course, that you look at mineral processing operations as a different dimension. Okay, so what sir is telling, that is what we practicing engineers were doing.
See, this is the curve what you have here for South African operations. That means what we call size by size recovery efficiency expressed through classical concepts of EP and imperfection. You will get lot of published data on EP and imperfection in literature. You will not get much, very little on organic efficiency.
Why do you give so much emphasis on organic efficiency?
Because plant operator sells.
I have got this entire coal, I am getting there, organic efficiency is 100%. How does it help?
I am selling everything, what I am supposed
no,
to
no,
sell.
I am having here, so I am not washing anything. I am not removing anything. So that is the simple thing, okay? What do I do with organic efficiency
even? Organic efficiency with that. There is a point.
No. Okay.
There is no science behind it. It is a purely commercial.
Recovery. It
is,
could be 100%.
Yeah.
Done nothing.
It is a pure commercial term.
I have got this. I have recovered here.
No, but the coal content should be acceptable, right? We cannot just sell.
No. I have got X amount of carbon in my feed coal. And I have not done anything, I have put it there. So I am recovering 100%, organic efficiency is 100%. How does it help?
If there is somebody who is willing to buy
it. No, it is not buying.
No, question of efficiency then would not arise because you have not done anything.
See, actually, buyers when they are not buying based on organic efficiency. It is organic efficiency for the washing performance you are looking at, okay, cleaning performance.
Plant operators.
But buyers always look at what is the calorimetric value or maybe what is the ash content of that. So, where is that question coming, organic efficiency? I don't understand.
All right. Okay. They have introduced a concept called breakaway size, South Africans, by breakaway size, they basically mean that up to a particle size of say around 5-6 millimeter, whatever efficiency values we obtain, they are pretty close to each other. There is not much difference. See, this is where it starts, 50 mm say the top size. So it is almost stable, 0.01, then say up to 0.015 to the size of around say 5 mm. But below 5 mm, the recovery efficiency drops drastically and it moves up almost to the vertical. So the size around which this change in the trend of the curve takes place, they call it breakaway size. And minimum the percentage of material in the breakaway size bracket, superior is the performance of the unit. Look at the data what we got from again Tata Steel plants. First of all, we are not getting any such steady curve. Yes, performance is good, not good, performance is better here when the top size is around 15 millimeter. You have 0.01, but then it keeps on increasing and it is not this way, it is steady increase. When the particle size comes down to 2 to 3 mm, then virtually the curve, it becomes very difficult to track the change. And this is where I took Dr. Mojumdar's help. And this is what he little bit hammered into my head through fluid mechanics, that 0.5 mm, 0.6 mm, 1 mm particle, they really don't act like a solid particle. So wherever water carries them under a given set of conditions, they go. If they go to clean coal, we say it's a very good, very efficient.
That will also depend on your fluid characteristics.
Yes. If it does not go, then we say, oh, it is. That means we don't have, while operating, we have very limited control over the movement of the particles, which are very small in size. This is what basically illustrates the difficulties in processing. It is possible that if I use a cyclone with a feed size, one cyclone with a feed size of say 16 mm to 3 mm and another cyclone parallel with a feed size of 3 mm to 0.5 mm, we would get a better performance. But that means, question is that improved performance, would it offset the investment made to get two parallel streams? That is not the case so far. With all improvement in design and everything, this is not the case. As a result, what happens? We keep on feeding the whole size range 13 to 0.5 or 15 to 0.5 to the same unit. And if percentage of fraction in breakaway size basket is high, our performance is poor. If that percentage of fraction is low, our performance is better. We say finer we crush, more we liberate coal matter from mineral matter. That is true, but it is also true, more we crush, more we produce fine particles, more and more difficult it becomes to recover. I have given some problems, and you try to do it. Our BTEC, for BTEC also there are few which they have not done, I am sure so far. But those who are not from BTEC mineral, for you all the problems are illustrative, and if you work on these problems, your understanding would be better. because we could not do numerical examples on certain things which I have shown here. You still have one evening, and see if you can do few problems. There will be some questions, right?
Yeah, but most of the people who will be appearing for this exam, they are chemical engineers, so I doubt whether they will be able to answer. Possibility.
No, if they do the exercise, they will be able to answer.
Yeah.
But if they don't do, I don't anyway. That is,
they are not attending
anyway, though. I mean, numericals always help in understanding of the subject. Okay, so I will close here.